So you're coming out guns blazing. What set this off?
Well, look, the business community feels that the FTC is waging a war against us, and it's time to fight back. You know, if you start with the executive order in July that kind of suggested our economy was too stagnant, that we're not innovating, that we're not fueling investment, that we're anti-competitive. That's not the America I live in. It's not the economy you cover every day. And we hear from CEOs all the time that the FTC's actions against competition are having a chilling effect on their activities.
It's not the first time she's gotten some tough condemnation. Facebook tried to have her recused from some cases. What kinds of remedies are you seeking? Are you asking her to step aside, to not weigh in on certain issues, or something else?
Look, this isn't personal. This is about an independent agency being clear on their rules, clear on their process, and understanding the businesses being able to understand what the rules of the road are. Are they actually an independent agency? When you were covering a few minutes ago, the White House calling on them to investigate the oil and gas industry over pricing, that's not how the FTC is supposed to be setting their agenda. So one thing is understand the rules of the road, understand if they're independent, understand who's voting. Is it really true that a former commissioner is voting, although he's no longer at the agency? And so really understanding the process is part of what we're trying to do, and also to rein in a really overzealous regulator.
Suzanne, we said we haven't gotten comment from the FTC. They did comment to the Journal, a spokesman saying the FTC just announced we're ramping up efforts to combat corporate crime, and now the chamber declares war on the agency, somehow linking those two. What's your response?
Well, it's ridiculous. You know, business owners are great members and pillars of their community across the country. And when they say to an agency, hey, we want to understand the rules of the road so that we can be good actors, the agency responding that they're criminals is just ridiculous. You know, I'll give you an example. These 1,800 companies that received letters, kind of public, you know, naming and shaming and saying, hey, you haven't really done anything wrong. But I'm putting you on notice that if you do something wrong, we may very well skip due process and go straight to the penalty stage. I mean, that is not how you treat ethical, normal business behavior from 1,800 companies.
And so from a practical level here, and to track where this might go, I mean, do you end up in court? You know, the letters themselves, obviously, we're having you on. We're going to talk about them. They're not unimportant. But where do you see this going? Or is there, in your mind, a potential for some sort of compromise here with Lina Khan and the FTC?
Look, we're not afraid of litigation. It's not what we want, right? We would like to not do it, but we're ready to do it. I mean, if we've litigated against overzealous regulators before, and if we have to do that to open up a black box and understand what the playing field is, then so be it.
Meantime, we got that to watch, and now we've got Build Back Better getting through the House. You guys have been unhappy with the construction of that bill for a while now. You have a statement out today saying that it would hurt American business. We'll see what happens in the Senate. Explain sort of where you think it falls short.
The Bring Back Bad Inflation Bill, the BBB, it falls short in a massive amount of government spending. Look, you cover inflation a lot, and rightly. If you think about the fact that a Thanksgiving turkey this year is going to cost the average American $5 more than last year, imagine what it's going to cost next year. I mean, we are in unprecedented times, inflation at a 31-year high. This can't possibly be the time to throw a whole bunch of cash into the system and use this process. And so it's got to be killed in the Senate, and we'll do everything we can to get that done.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.